So one day, me and my boyfriend had to go to a formal event, and he didn't have a bow tie. So instead of him going to the shop looking for one, I decided to make one myself, being the good girlfriend that I am. So today I'll show you step by step how to make a bow tie at home. And it's really easy, so anybody can do it. Firstly, what you'll need is a piece of fabric, anything that you think is suitable to make a bow tie off. Secondly, you'll need scissors, some measuring tape or a ruler, some elastic for around the neck, as something to mark the lines where you have to sew with, and also a needle and thread. So the first step will be measuring and cutting. You'll need one square of about 13 by 12 centimeters, one of about 9 by 9, and one about 4 by 8 centimeters. After that, before we move on, we have to iron the fabric. This is very important throughout the whole process, and it'll pretty much just make everything much easier. Then we'll need a chalk or a pencil, something that is easily erasable, to draw a line around the edges of the square after we folded it in half. This will just make sure that you sew straight and on the line and that we have a symmetrical bow tie. After drawing the lines, it is as simple as just start sewing. Usually I'll be sewing with a machine, but for the sake of showing everybody that it's as easy as this, and you only need a needle and thread for making this, I'm making it with hand today. So after sewing two sides of every rectangle, it's time to turn it outside inside. So we pretty much just push everything inside to hide the seam allowance and to have the brighter stripes on the outside. Then, as I mentioned before, ironing is very important. So I will iron it. Firstly, I will iron it flat to make sure the corners are out. And then I will turn inside the top part that hasn't been sewed to make it easier to hand sew after I ironed it. After you're sure that you have ironed the fabric on the right place, we'll be doing something called invisible stitching. This basically just means that you'll be making hand stitches inside the fold without the stitches being seen. If you watch closely, you'll see that it's really easy. After the invisible stitches on both these two rectangles, I will place the small one on top of the big one and then use this long one to wrap around these two together. Now all I have to do is sew the back of this long rectangle so that this can stay in this shape. And finally, we have a bow tie. We don't have any way to attach it yet, so this is where the elastic comes in. It's a quick fix, and this is not always what people use. Sometimes they'll use a clip or they'll use a piece of the same fabric to attach it to the back of the neck. It's up to you, and you can be creative also by the way that you want to attach it. For this one though, we'll need to put it through the back of the bow tie and sew the end like this. And then you can just stretch it to put it over your neck, which means you don't have to measure the exact neck width.